that we now behold is nothing more than a wilderness inhabited by wild animals. But that's only the beginning. Look here. How's this? And this? And that? One big bag of joy.
Hi, I'm Robert Osborne. The Academy Award-winning animation director Chuck Jones is TCM's Man of the Night. Next, we have a film that earned Jones the first of his two Academy Awards. Now, years later, he'd receive a Lifetime Achievement Oscar for his body of work. That was in 1995, but his first Oscar was a competitive one, awarded to him for a short he made in 1965. Made not at his usual stomping grounds of Warner Brothers, but instead for Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer, where he began working in 1963 after being fired by Warner Brothers. And that firing was rooted in Warner's displeasure that Jones had moonlighted and done an animated feature called Gay Paree. Warner's fired him when they found out that Jones had violated the terms of his exclusive contract with the company by doing that movie. The irony was that Warner Brothers ended up distributing that film, Gay Paree. But being fired didn't faze Jones. Immediately, he began his own independent production company, and it was soon purchased by MGM. Thus, Jones became an MGM employee. His primary assignment at MGM was to create new Tom and Jerry cartoons, although MGM also allowed him to do side projects, and our next short is one of those. The title is The Dot and the Line, a romance in lower mathematics. It's based on a book by Norton Juster about the unrequited love a straight line has for a dot. But the dot finds the line too rigid and boring and would rather spend quality time with a wild squiggly line. Isn't that just like a dot for you? Here's a great love story, though, so cleverly told, and it's narrated by Robert Morley and brought Chuck Jones an Academy Award. Here's The Dot and the Line. Hi, I'm Robert Osborne. Like our last short about The Dot and the Line, our next animated short from Chuck Jones was also made for MGM. And it's quite a historic film. It's the last animated short that MGM ever made. Now, at this point, the studio had been making cartoon shorts for over 30 years. But after this next one, which is called The Bear That Wasn't, Chuck Jones made an animated feature called The Phantom Tollbooth. And then after that, MGM's animation department focused solely on work for television. Even MGM's famous duo, Tom and Jerry, were retired from the silver screen. But that was the nature of the movie business in the late 60s. At least Chuck Jones was able to work with many old friends on this farewell project. The Bear That Wasn't is based on a children's book by Frank Tashlin, who years before had worked with Chuck Jones in the Warner Brothers animation department. Tashlin's story is about a bear who wakes up after a long winter's hibernation to discover a factory has been built around his lair. And when he runs into the men working in the factory, they don't see a bear. They see a hairy man in a fur coat, and the bear can't convince them otherwise. So the question is, will the bear accept his fate and be something he's not? Or will he go back to being, well, just a bear in a world no longer familiar to him? From 1967, directed by Chuck Jones, here's The Bear That Wasn't.